Okay, so we're continuing our discussion of integration, and we're looking now at a great application of integration and how we can use it. So we've learned so many different methods for integration, but from here in this video, we're going to be applying the use of a computer algebra system. So it's going to make our job a lot easier, and this video is going to run really fast. But let's take a look at this. A probability density function for a continuous random variable is a function f defined over an interval from negative to positive infinity, and it has the following three properties. Number one, the function has to be continuous, except possibly at some finite number of points. Number two, the function has to be non-negative, that is, that f has to be greater than or equal to zero. And lastly, when you integrate the function from negative to positive infinity, you should get one. So this third point here should ring a bell because we're getting at improper integrals. So we may run into improper integrals in this video. And actually, we're not going to, but what we're doing here is we're going to be doing some integration techniques. So notice the use here of the variable x, but in a capital case. It says, if x is a continuous random variable with probability density function f, the probability then that x assumes a value in the interval between x equals c and d is the area integral. So we're going to be utilizing that here. All right. Now, in the examples that we're looking at, though, in this video, we're going to be checking if a particular function is a probability density function. And the quick check there is it's got to be continuous, it's got to be non-negative. And then, of course, the interval that we're looking at it from has to evaluate to equal one. All right, so let's go ahead and take a look at the first example. All right, it says, are the following PDFs over the given interval? So here's the first one. It says f of x equals 1 over 32x from 0 to 8. Well, fortunately for us, this function is continuous and it is non-negative from 0 to 8. All right, so what we have to do then is we have to do the integration from 0 to 8. And we should get 1 over 32x dx, and we need it to equal 1. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we might see on a computer algebra system. So, utilizing in this case what I used was Wolfram Alpha, and I'm going to point out here exactly what I typed on Wolfram Alpha. All right, I typed this out, and notice what I got as my answer. I got 1. So, this is indeed 1. So, the question was, is this a probability density function, a PDF? And the answer, of course, is yes. So, the answer here for this one is yes. So, let's go ahead and take a look at another function value here, another potential PDF. All right, so we're going to look at f of x equals, and then this one is going to be 1/4 of x, and this one we're going to be viewing from the interval from 4 to 7. All right, so we're going to follow basically the same technique that we just did. All right, and that is we're going to go from 4 to 7, we're going to integrate 1/4 x dx, and what should it equal? It should equal 1. So let's go ahead and take a look at what Wolfram Alpha has to say about that. So notice here what Wolfram Alpha says. All right, it says 4.125. This is exactly what we typed in, and the output looks exactly like what we need it to look like. So in this case, because it evaluates to be 4.125, this does not equal 1, which was the third requirement of the PDF, because this function, of course, is continuous and non-negative. All right. But it's not equal to 1, so we say here our answer is, of course, no. All right, let's go ahead and take a look at one more example. We'll call this one number 3. All right, and here we're going to be taking a look at the function, an exponential function, 7 to the power x. And the interval that we're going to be looking at is rather interesting. This is going to go from 0 to this number, and you may like this number, you may hate this number. All right, but look at where it's going to. It's going to the natural log of 1 plus the natural log of 7, all divided by the natural log of 7. Very interesting. It'll be interesting to type out for sure on Wolfram Alpha. So let's go ahead and take a look at what this looks like as I write it out. So I'm going to go from 0, and then I'm going to go to the natural log of 1 plus the natural log of 7, close that off, divide divided by the natural log of 7. So that's definitely an interesting problem to take a look at. All right, and let's see, it's going to be 7 to the power x dx. All right, so let's take a look at what Wolfram Alpha has to say about that, because remember, if this is indeed a PDF, it should equal 1. So let's take a look. So this one, in fact, does equal 1. So the question of whether or not it's a PDF, well, the answer is yes, it indeed is a PDF, a probability density function. All right, so I want to point out again, look at what we've done. We're utilizing a computer algebra system, and I'm giving you exactly what it is to type in to try to integrate these very quickly. All right, as always, I hope this video was helpful, and remember, like and subscribe.